And one of our huge strengths is our daunting defense. I'd say we have a really strong defensive line, linebackers, a front seven that can really get the job done.
Another loaded prep sports extra for you this evening. Dylan Hudgens in that Minnetonka defense facing a massive challenge tonight against undefeated foe Shakopee. Julia, what do you have for us?
Will in Class 5A Armstrong hoping to stay undefeated against St. Thomas Academy. Plus, we check in with Hopkins as they continue a stunning turnaround this fall.
Jason Eagle, D-line, Spring Lake Park, Prep Sports Extra starts now.
Hi again, everybody. Welcome to Prep Sports Extra. Alongside Julia Daniels, I'm Will Hall. We start out tonight with our spotlight game in Minnetonka for a matchup of two undefeated teams in Class 6A.
Yeah, Will, this one was bound to bring out some true colors.
Yeah.
Mark Ash has quite the crew and the quarterback in Caleb Francois. Ray Benton and his weapon, running back TJ Clark. This one at the Skipper's house tonight, and that's exactly who strikes first. Chase Conrad, 10-yard rushing touchdown to put Tonka up 7-0, but they aren't done yet. Francois, he's going to find Conrad through the air this time.
Oof,
14-0. Skippers. We move to the third quarter. Malachi Bodhi Abugadwe. Check out this pick.
Like a center fielder.
Interception. Tonka has it back again, and Skippers cash in on this one. Francois with the sneak to give Minnetonka a 21-0 lead. And the nail in the coffin, it's Malachi. Another pick. Tonka goes on to take this one a final 21-13.
Close game, close finish. What a night from Malachi. Adam Spurrell and Maple Grove hosting Blank tonight. Pick things up in the first. Crimson strike first. North Dakota commit Chuck Langama off tackle.
Of course.
Punishing run ends in the end zone. Crimson up 7-0. Later in the first half, Gayden Harney rolling right off play action. Finds Cornell commit.
Wow.
Bo Draheim. And Big Bo says, ho, 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 Santa, give me a tutty. Maple Grove stays undefeated, 35-0 the final.
All right, we go to Lakeville North as they hosted Eagan tonight. North undefeated ahead of this one. Pick things up after the half. North leads 22-18. Gage Halverson, 40-yard run-in.
Eagan.
That puts Eagan up 25-22. Next drive, North, Riley Grossman.
Ooh.
Sebastian Fry, 32-yard connection for that one on the one, and Sam Riplinger takes advantage with
Sam.
The score. North holds on to win this one. The final tonight, a tight win, 36-33.
Special season brewing for Coach Bossen and company. Ben Burke in Lakeville South hosting Rochester Mayo in a shootout. Mayo's Isaiah Beal, the 16-yard touchdown run. South still up, 28-21. They would answer right back. Gavin Dean up the seam. 24-yard touchdown pass to Henry Haug. South wins a thriller, 46-43 the final.
Wow. Over in Edina, the Hornets hosting Prior Lake. When I got there at the half, things were all tied up at 14.
Ooh.
Edina gets the go-ahead when Chase, say this with me.
Bjorgaard
rolls into the end zone to make it 21-14. Prior Lake not staying down literally at all. Kickoff after that last Hornet score.
How about that?
Kai Green finds and hits the seam. One Hornet left standing, it's the kicker, but he's got nothing. Green 95 yards
wow.
to the house. Hornets put another one up before the end, though. It's 28-21, Edina, the final.
Edina hanging on. I might feel like we see that in hot highlights.
I think so, too.
Forest Lake hosting Stillwater, pick things up in the first. Ponies to the air, Nick Kinsey dropping one right in the bread basket to Owen Eggy. What a pass from Kinsey for the score. Rangers answer right back, though. This is Mac Jerkovich on the option. 80-yard house call down
wow.
the sideline. Brad Bisco in Forest Lake with a big OT win. 27-21 the final.
Another hot highlight?
Yeah, how about that? Dipping down to 5A. Armstrong hoping to stay undefeated tonight against St. Thomas Academy. Falcons star running back Kevon Johnson gets to the edge and the pylon for the score. Armstrong moves to 5-0. 20-14, the final.
All right, we head to Holy Angels as the Stars hosted Totino Grace. Eagles strike first in the second quarter. Handoff to Markel Keaton. He does the rest, 38 Ooh. Yards. House call, it's 7-0. Totino Grace. Same quarter, Eagles firing again. This time a handoff to Michael Strong. And it's another six for TG. They go on to win this one with a final tonight, 28-14. 12.
TD still undefeated. Speaking of undefeated, undefeated Orono hosting Mount Washtenka tonight. Spartans leading early. It's Perk's son, George Perkins, going 35 yards on the screen, laying out the extension all the way to the house. Big congrats to the Perkins household. Late in the half, Whitehawks threatening to score when Alex Loveless, feeling the love, gets the pick to end the threat. Spartans win this one. All right, taking a look at some of the scores from around the state. In 6A, Wayzata knocks off EP. Park of Cottage Grove falls to Hopkins in a thriller.
Wow, look at the Royals. Chan over Mankato West, and we've got Mankato East over Waconia.
Moving along here in 4A, how about Becker going on the road? They knock off Hutchinson in a big romp. And then it's North Branch taking down Duluth Denfield.
And in Class 3A, we've got Dassel Cokato over Litchfield and a big one for Fairmount. Fairmont, Newham.
Moving ahead here, we've got some 2A, 1A scores. This is Chatfield taking down Triton and Bold knocking off Dawson Boyd.
Hot Highlights is sponsored by TrueStone Financial.
And this week's Hot Highlight winner is Brady Jensen, catching an 85-yard touchdown pass for Andover last week when they beat Elk River. Juju, take it away.
You know what we're going to do. One quick look at this winner from Jensen, he catches that pass from quarterback Hudson Maynard. That brings home a nice payday for the Andover Huskies, thanks to TrueStone.
4-3 speed right there. Coming up after the break, we catch up with the Hopkins Royals.
Yeah, Will, you chatted with the team earlier this week in the midst of a historic season.
Hi, I'm Owen Lampson. I'm a receiver. I go to St. Francis High School, and you're watching Prep Sports Extra.
One of the better coaching jobs in the state this season is happening over at Hopkins, where a new staff is finding immediate results.
Set, go.
Things have been hard for the Hopkins football team.
I was still having fun. It was just the winning aspect of football just wasn't there.
For first-year head coach Chauncey Williams-Bearfield,
you know, we really worked hard on instilling a good culture.
Hard is something he's never shied away from. In fact, hard is the very foundation of his program.
Our team philosophy is go hard. It's honest, accountable, relentless, and disciplined.
Those pillars have led to a shift this fall for the Royals.
Coach Chauncey's a great coach. You know, I feel like I've learned a lot. He's a great man, teaches a lot of good, valuable life lessons. And
we feel we have a really, really talented coaching staff this year and players, so we knew we could win.
The Hopkins program entered the season having not won a varsity game since November 11, 2020. 29 consecutive losses by an average margin of defeat of 42 points.
For you to put in all that work, blood, sweat, tears, energy into something and not to be able to taste the reward of it with a win for 3+ years, this is tough.
On September 13th, 1,402 days after their last varsity win, the Royals beat Eastview in overtime.
Saw my friend Tanner, who's also a senior captain, and he was crying, so we just hugged each other, cried for like 5 minutes. I don't think I'll ever have a greater sports experience than that in my life.
Two key aspects of the turnaround include star basketball player Jaden Moore playing this fall.
He's special. You know, just athletically, there's not many kids as athletic as he is.
He entered this week leading the state in receiving yards this season, joining his freshman brother Trey, who starts at quarterback for the Royals.
Oh, it's been amazing. It's been great. That brother connection, it's been great. Experiencing this is like cool. Like, we used to, back in our neighborhood, we play all the time. So,
ready? Gaps, baby.
Scheming up the dynamic Moore duo is former Gophers quarterback Brian Cupido, the Royals' first-year offensive coordinator.
He's been amazing. He helped me sleep very well at night knowing that I don't have to worry about the offense.
Those ingredients all helping propel the Royals to new heights this fall.
I've been part of a lot of teams, and this is different. This is special.
Including a new type of streak.
Yeah, no reason to stop. Doesn't matter who we're playing now.
You know, I'm just really happy to be a part of history, you know, finally breaking the streak. And the best part about it is that we just started a new streak.
1, 2, 3, earn it!
Big congrats to Hopkins.
Love to see it.
How about that? They won their third game in a row tonight. They improved to 3-3 this season. 57-50, the final over Park of Cottage Grove. That's going to do it this week for Prep Sports Extra. We'll see you same time, same place next Friday.